Welcome back, and you're still watching The Breakfast Show on Nine International. And right now we have a very interesting topic, which is obesity, which is a medical condition in which excess body fat has accumulated to the extent it may have an adverse effect on health, leading to reduced life expectancy or increased health problems. And to shed more light on the issue, we are delighted to have with us today Dr. Munir William Labib, Professor of Plastic Surgery and Nutrition Consultant. Sir, we thank you so much for joining us. Good morning.
So, sir, what, doctor, I wanted to ask you, what can you tell us about obesity?
Obesity is increased body weight by 15% or more from the corresponding standard weight related to age, sex, race, and height. Mm-hmm. Of course, we have to differentiate between obesity and edema. Edema is accumulation of fluids inside the body. So edema, and also edema, we find increased body weight. Mm-hmm. But here, due to accumulation of fluids inside the body, maybe due to hepatic causes related to liver, or maybe due to cardiac causes related to the heart, or even renal causes related to the kidney.
Very different reasons.
Also, obesity itself, we have to put in mind there is differentiation between two types of obesity. Obesity due to increased number of fat cells, which is named hyperplastic obesity, and it is present usually below puberty. And second type of obesity, what is known as hypertrophic obesity, it is increase in the body weight due accumulation of fat due to increase in size of fat cells and not increasing of number of fat cells, and it is present after puberty. Mm-hmm. So here it is a very wide spectrum to speak about, but here is lies obesity.
But is it related to a certain age, or?
No, it is not related, and this leads us to speak about causes of obesity. Mm-hmm. Cause of obesity, many causes. First cause is hereditary cause. Hereditary cause, it is due to presence of gene specific on chromosome number 17. This is proved later on. Second cause is metabolic causes. It is maybe due to metabolic problems such as diabetes mellitus. Mm-hmm. Usually we find in about 75% of obese patients there is diabetes, and 25% of diabetic patients are obese. Third cause is endocrine causes for obesity. There are many causes for endocrine. For example, there is problem in the pituitary gland, which is lies in the brain, or there is problem in the thyroid gland, which lies in front of the neck, mm-hmm. or there is problem in the suprarenal gland, which lies above the kidney. All these three problems may lead to formation of obesity. Mm-hmm. Also, there is a fourth cause, which is the psychic cause. We usually hear from some persons say that we are needed to, there are many problems in front of us, and we relieve these problems in eating. This is a psychic cause.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The last cause for my own problem is the habits in itself, habits themselves. For example, eating during watching TV, or reading newspaper, or hearing radio, this makes the person eat more. These are, in general, the main causes for obesity. Mm-hmm.
And also, sir, you mentioned that it could be hereditary. So that's very dangerous, because then how do you combat obesity when it's in your genes?
Of course, hereditary causes just means that you can control it from the start. And I mean by hereditary, not means increased body weight as a general.
Mm-hmm.
But we might find obesity hereditary related to the breast. There is huge breast present in certain families.
Mm-hmm.
Or related to the pelvis. We find wide pelvis and huge pelvis related to other families. And maybe related to upper parts of the thigh. All these are hereditary causes. So you can, from the start, say what type of hereditary causes, and you can control it from the start.
So, sir, what are the dangers an obese person is exposed to? I mean, what are the dangers, the diseases you can get?
At first, in the last century, we can say that obesity is one of certain diseases. But now, obesity itself is a disease. So we can find many dangers. Every part inside the body suffers from obesity. For example, I suffer from retinal hemorrhage. Cardiac problems may suffer from accumulation of fat on wall of blood vessels and capillaries and leads to cardiac hypertension, cardiac problems, ischemia, and so on. Brain may suffer from hemorrhage related to obesity. Also, hypertension, atherosclerosis is a problem of obesity. maybe there may be accumulation of some fat cells at sebaceous glands behind the skin, and this related to obesity. Mm-hmm. Diabetes related to obesity. As you see, no right, organ inside the body cannot suffer from obesity. Yes,
it's course. Like the core for all. But Sarah, I wanted to ask you, how could you combat obesity if you haven't from the start realized that you have the gene or that you're a psychological eater? If you have these four cases, what little things can you do to start combating obesity if you're at that level already?
And are there symptoms as well for obesity? Mm-hmm.
Yes, I can say from to come back to obesity from my own way, I can say that there are three lines of treatment or lines of behavior. Mm-hmm. The first line of behavior is diet control. Everyone has to diet control himself. I don't like regimen and so on, and this type of regime and this chemical and this related to meal and so on. No, I can say every person can ask himself every day, is he going to have moderate effort or hard effort or mild effort, and then he has to multiply his body weight by 40 if there is hard effort and there is some number of calories, or by 37 in moderate effort, or by 34 in simple effort. So suppose my weight is 70 kilograms, mm-hmm. and I am going to hard effort today, so I have to multiply 70 by 40 and there is 2080 calories. So I can choose my diet today by from 2,800 calories, and this is my diet today. Suppose tomorrow I am going to have a simple effort, I have to multiply my body weight, which is 70, by 34. And there is number of calories, and I have to arrange my self to this number of calories.
But the maximum number of calories is?
Is multiplied according to my effort. This is okay. From my own opinion. Uh-huh. And then I can say to any person that, all vegetables are allowed except potato and sweet potatoes. All types of fruits are allowed except banana and mango and dates. Also, I can say to the person and to the housewife who is cooking that you have to put the ratio of unsaturated fatty acids, which are oil liquid in the normal temperature, such as oil, to the ratio of saturated fatty acids, which are solid at the normal temperature, such as butter, the ratio may be 2 unsaturated to 1 saturated. This is mm-hmm. the housewife in the in house
general.
In general. And if you do this, this is the first line of treatment, which is diet control. Mm-hmm. Second line of treatment is exercise or sports control. This is very important because if we are allowed to do exercise, even by small amount, even by walking, mm-hmm. this helps. Number one, so destruction of fat is the first line of destruction of calories, and this decreases body weight. Number two, this walking or sports or exercise allows decreased amount of precipitation of low density triglycerides on walls of capillaries and blood vessels, and so the patient suffers minimum from cardiac problems and brain problems and so on. Mm-hmm. Number three, exercise and sports less than the destruction of fats which is present in muscles, less than the destruction of fats which is present in subcutaneous tissue and the abdomen and so on, and this makes the person stronger. This is the line, second line of treatment. First line is diet control, the second line is exercise control. Third line is will. Mm-hmm. Every person must has the will that there is diet control and sport control all over his life.
I think it's the most important thing.
This is
the
most
important. I love food, so that will be the first part I would concentrate on, honestly.
Once you love food, you are in need for plastic surgery.
Plastic surgery.
Yes.
Plastic surgery, great.
And here's Dr. Munir.
Yeah, so after the show, we can schedule a time.
Okay, so you're talking about smokers. Some people think that smoking can play a positive role in losing weight. So do you think this is a right thing?
This is a right thing, but we have to keep in mind that smoking a decreased amount of certain amino acid present inside the body named tryptophan. This amino acid passes to the brain and allows the brain to secrete substance called melanotin. This melanotin is very important.
Melanotin. Okay.
This substance is secreted by the brain. Mm-hmm. And this substance is very important. Smoking prevents secretion of this substance. And this substance helps the body to be calm, helps the body to withstand the pain, helps the body to decrease fats. Mm-hmm. So smoking is very important in this problem because it, here it allows the body to accumulate fat. But of course, many other serious and dangerous problems related to the fat. And so I am with the opinion to stop smoking and to diet control, exercise control, and will avail.
Mm-hmm. But what are the magic solutions, the quick solutions to losing all that fat?
As I have said, there are three main lines of treatment. Otherwise, we shall speak about the role of surgery. In order mm-hmm. to speak about the role of plastic surgery, we have to divide the obesity into three types, according to what is known as mass number. What is mass number? Mass number is a division. It is a number of body weight in kilograms divided by square of the height in meters.
Okay.
Suppose the body weight in kilograms is 80, and body so 80 kilograms is divided by, suppose my height is 176, mm-hmm. so it is divided by 1.76 square. And so here there is a number. This number is very important, what is known as mass number in distribution and division and dividing the obesity into three types.
Mm-hmm.
Suppose this mass number is between, below 15, there is senility. There is no obesity, there is senility. Between 15 and 25, this is a certain type which is normal person. From 25 to 30, this is a mild obesity. From 30 to 40, this is a moderate obesity. More than 40, this is a morbid obesity. Let's speak about each one and the role of plastic surgery alone. In mild obesity, there is only accumulation of fat in certain areas inside the body.
Mm-hmm.
Suppose upper part of the hand, suppose upper our inner or outer sides of the thigh, and so on, or even arms.
Mm-hmm.
Here, liposuction plays an important role in treatment of mild obesity.
Mm-hmm.
So liposuction is a process in which you have to arrange the contour of the body, reshape the body. And here it is not the process of decreasing but weight. It's an operation for reconstruction of the body. So this is the for
mm-hmm.
mild obesity.
Uh-huh.
For moderate obesity, for example, there is a person who has huge abdomen or bendulous abdomen, or a woman after many labor, there is a bendulous abdomen. This type of moderate obesity, there is three operations to be done on the same time. The first operation for the abdomen is liposuction of the anterior abdominal wall. The second operation is the application of vertebrae, which are muscles. There is a type of herniation inside mm-hmm. the abdominal wall in the abdomen. So the second operation in the same time to be done is the application of the vertebrae, is the removal of this hernia. And third operation is excision of excess fat, which is present below the abdomen.
Mm-hmm.
So these three operations must be done alone in one sitting. If the doctor operates only one, you will find still there is a problem. If the doctor operates just liposuction, there is still a bendulous abdomen. If he doesn't duplicate the rectus, there is still a bendulous abdomen. If there is no excess fat to be excised, still there is a bendulous abdomen. So the three operations must be done on the same setting. For morbid obesity or huge obesity, there are two types of or two lines of treatment. The first line of treatment depends on gastric restrictions. We are blaming on stomach. The second operation is what is known as malabsorption syndrome. We are blaming on the intestine. Suppose the doctor is blaming on the stomach, there is two operations which are very famous and common. First operation, what is known as gastric stripping or stomach stripping.
Mm-hmm.
Second operation is application of the ring around the stomach.
Yeah.
In the other operation, which is in the malabsorption, if we are operating the intestine, there is either bypass operation, in which we have to perform a channel between the stomach and the ends of the small intestine. All these operations, I don't like to enter in details, are playing an important role in decreasing the amount of diet which is entering inside the body.
There are some people but fear plastic surgery, mm-hmm. and they usually don't think about it because they fear it. So how do you like to comfort them about plastic surgery?
I have said from the start, this is the last line of treatment. They must diet control, exercise mm-hmm. manner, and goodwill. Otherwise, there must be a plastic surgery.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, this will affect their lives, of course.
Mm-hmm.
We don't find elder person who is fat and busting, something helping him because they are already dead.
You see that our everyday life in Cairo especially, is that susceptible to obesity? Because, for example, walking in the street sometimes is difficult. all of these aspects, do they lead to a person becoming obese?
I don't like to brush in this way. Mm-hmm. Obesity is a manner, and it relates to the personality, the person himself. Here there is a relation to the personality. If you are trying to respect your body, you are doing your exercise well, you are doing your work well, you have a good will, you have your diet is controlled, no spicy food or fast food, and so on, so on, so on, you are controlling your body.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like to say that the mother in house has a great problem for doing this. She is preparing the diet, and when the diet is delicious and full of fruits and fat and vegetables, I think no person will try to eat from outside the house.
But yeah, but talking about the
don't blame the housewife.
For me, myself, I like fat.
Yes, I think. How could you cook without fat?
But it doesn't appear on you. Because you are doing the best ratio of unsaturated to unsaturated fatty acid, of course.
Yeah, you're right. But so you're talking about the percentage of obese people here in Egypt. So, Rahma, I think you wanted to know the percentage and compare it with other countries.
Yeah, maybe.
The percentage of obesity here is less than that of the United States.
Mm-hmm.
In the United States, more than 10 to 12%.
Mm-hmm.
Here it is less than 2%.
That's perfect, yeah.
Yes,
we hope that it's
0%.
Yes, I find that from all my life, I have found many, many lots of obese persons present, for example, in the States, even in Russia. Here ratio is less, but if we control our life, we'll be better.
Do you remember any success story that you would like to tell us about, or any even strange story that you've encountered during your profession?
Of course, I'd like to say that we have to respect sports, we have to respect work.
Mm-hmm.
This is very important, and we have to have a will to control our diet. The second measure. Third one, you have to decrease amount of fast foods, which are contained lots of saturated fats, which are very serious to the liver and serious to the body, and leads to accumulation of all the triglycerides, walls of capillaries, and of course this leads to cardiac and catastrophes and brain hemorrhage and so on. And all these are very important. So we have to respect our exercise control. This is very important. And I don't like any person to perform heavy exercise and then stop suddenly. Once you are going exercise and then you stop suddenly, there is huge problems to come.
It has to be gradually. I think people will come fast.
And most of our patients, they were healthy during early life. They were healthy and related to class. And soon or later, they stopped exercise and stay in remote control and stay in least movement, and then they become obese in every part of the body. We find the
person. Do you remember? But do you remember any one of your patients you would like to talk about to us? Any of your patients? We want to know a success story or people who have
anyone who's lost 30 kilograms.
Yeah.
For my own, all my patients are famous persons, and, and I think they.
So without mentioning names.
Without mentioning names.
I think one of the person, my persons who weighed was about 180 kilograms.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
This person comes to the hospital on a car. He was in on a huge car. And they were, I have chosen a hospital in which the operating room is the floor downwards because he cannot move to upstairs. And this person, I have operated him twice. One operation for the abdomen, for dermolibectomy. Second operation after about 1 month was for his thighs.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I was glad because this person can go alone to his car and return home. But after two and a half months.
Yeah, well, wow.
So these problems, these operations are very serious, and patients suffer a lot. And during the operation, there are many problems in anesthesia, problems during work, problems during the post-operative operation. Of course, we have to control our life and control our
diet. So in order to avoid that next step of surgery, of in need of operations, we should start earlier on to make it a habit or a way of life for us to control our diet and to have the will to control our diet.
I don't like self.
Mm-hmm.
I do like diet control and exercise control and will.
Mm-hmm.
But unfortunately, all my life is self.
But it's good that a plastic surgeon says that.
Yes, exactly. Yes,
of course.
So, sir, is there a specific message you would like to tell to Egyptians or obese people?
My message is you have to control your life by specific type of diet control. And as I said in the start, every person can put his diet daily for him. He is saying, now I am today, I'm going to hard effort, so my body weight is so and so, multiplied by 40, my calories today is so and so. So I can eat everything, but within this number of calories today. Every one person also says to him, second day I am going to moderate work, so I have to control my diet today, my calories is my body weight times 57, so it is about so and so calories, so my diet today is within these calories and my effort is within this effort, and every person can have a look for himself. And this is my message to every person. Don't forget exercise. You have to control your diet daily and have a look. You have the will to be in healthy life all over your life. And my message to the, any mother in house, you have to have a look for your husband and have a look for your baby. And you are responsible for him all over their life as long as they are breathing inside house. This is my message for all. And so we are going in revolution.
And you have to be responsible too. You have to be responsible.
Let's see that there is a revolution in our life and style as
exactly.
A revolution.
Yeah. Definitely. And lastly, sir, we wanted to ask you before we finalize the episode, what do you think about people who eat more during winter or eat more during summer? Because I've always been interested in how weather affects our food habits.
Is there a specific diet you would like to tell us about for people who eat more in winter and autumn?
No. Every person has to put his diet and his manner and all his diet according to his weight, and he has to choose. Suppose you are in need to eat chocolate today, and you have some about 2,000 calories today.
So
and this chocolate, you can eat from this. And there's some types of food you are in need to eat. I don't prevent any person. For you have to eat something such as so and so and so, and never to eat so and so and so. No. Every person can eat freely, with freedom. You can choose his diet as what he wants. In winter as he likes, in summer as he likes, and so on. I don't like
thing,
to put restrictions on life.
I think
once you put restrictions on life, every person will say that I have done a regime for 6 months and was so and so and so, and then prevented, and then I become with collapse and worse than
they
before.
They come depressed and then they come back.
And then you eat again what you've been ignoring.
My opinion is never, to restrict the diet, never to put regime. Every person is responsible for himself. He has to put his diet as he likes. This is my opinion.
So Dr. Munir William Labib, Professor of Plastic Surgery and Nutrition Consultancy, thank you so much for being with us.
Yeah, Yasmin and I will go exercise now.
Okay.
You've motivated us.
You are in me.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
So, and now we will move to some light news. So stay tuned.